Solijma heeft er ook zo eentje. Solijma, you woke up tomorrow 5 a.m.?
4 o'clock, man.
Wow, 4 o'clock.
It's a long drive here.
Oh, you came here by car from Denmark.
Because we have to bring all the instruments.
Oh.
What should we play on?
And how long was it driving?
Then we came into kind of a snowstorm. Did you hear about that?
A snowstorm?
Like Germany was full of snow.
Oh, we had a windy
storm
tomorrow.
Yeah, then we came into your country and it was like wind. And then we arrived at Groningen.
Groningen.
And the sun was like high on the sky, so...
Well, it's
like
good to have
a great
you
welcome.
I'm very thankful for you being here. I read in an interview that you describe your music as garage pop. Mm. What do you mean by that?
Actually, it was my producer Vasco. He's back here playing with me today. It was his idea, and it's this idea that we blend organic elements with electronic elements in our songs.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean with organic elements?
Like to record a real drum kit upon something electronic you have recorded, or to like use a real guitar and blend it with some kind of produced elements. Does it make sense?
Yeah, it makes sense to me. I also hear some R&B influences in your music. Mm. Is that from a far past? Because you used to play in a hip hop formation, right?
I did. Yes.
I checked it out as well. The name is, correct me if I'm wrong, Fleur de Clinique.
Oh, you're so good.
Thank you.
Your Danish is perfect.
Danke.
Yes.
But how was that?
It was super good, but I mainly played the piano.
Uh-huh.
And so that I guess that was where I kind of learned to play with other people.
And
very
then,
much.
And then you decided just to quit that and to start all on your own.
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
I feel there's another history you don't
want
to talk about.
Let's leave. Invite me another day.
Okay, I'll do that. But besides hip-hop and R&B, I think there's another influence maybe in your music because you've lived in Tanzania, right?
Yeah, I did.
And how did that influence your music?
Oh, very much. It influenced me musically and also very much personally.
Well, first personally.
Oh, I became a better person. I think it's important to go out in the world and learn about it. And I did that at a very good time in my life. I met some amazing people.
And what did you learn? Can you give us one example?
Musically, for example, I learned to understand what it means to play together with other people. Mm-hmm. Here we sang a lot together and we played the Punungula drum, which is this native Sukuma drum from Mwanza in Tanzania. And here people play together in a way I've never heard anywhere after that and before.
And how is it to be here at Eurosonic and to bring all those influences together and to play them for, well, the people in Groningen, but also to other musicians from all over Europe?
It's amazing. It's such a good feeling to be here. It's very special when everyone comes together in these kind of things. There's the special energy of everyone just like wanting to get the best from each other somehow, and that's a really strong feeling actually. Mm-hmm. So I'm excited about tonight, really.
Well, first tonight before your gig, you're gonna play for us here another
Yay!
Song, right? Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks for
playing for us live. You're gonna play Low Life, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Good
Thank
luck.
Thank you.